My name is Anne Baar and I study sediment transport in morphodynamic models. Morphodynamic models are frequently used to predict the development of fluvial and tidal systems in both scientific and engineering studies. For example, to optimize flood protection, shipping fairway maintenance, or to predict the long-term evolution on the changing sea level or changing sediment input. However, most models predict unrealistically high channel incision and need calibration to reach a stable equilibrium. The most effective method is to increase the transverse bed slope effect. The transverse bed slope parameter determines the amount of sediment that is deflected downslope on slopes that are transverse to the main flow direction. Therefore, increasing this parameter results in more sediment downslope that counteracts the extreme channel incision in models. However, the transverse bed slope effect is poorly understood, and choices made by modelers result in up to 2 orders of magnitude more downslope sediment transport. This raises the question whether the process in the model is physically correct or if other sediment transport processes are missing. We conducted over 250 experiments in the lab to quantify the physical processes that influence sediment transport on transverse bed slopes. Experiments were conducted in a rotating annular flume, in which we could vary flow velocities, vent flow intensities and sediment sizes. Results show a novel relation between the transverse slope effect and flow conditions. And this relation depends on grain size, which determines the mobility of the sediment, bed form dimensions and whether the sediment is transported as bed load or in suspension. Even though we now have a better understanding of the transverse bed slope effect, this did not explain the severe incision in the morphodynamic models. This means that increased transverse sediment transport is necessary to compensate for absent model processes. Therefore, we ran several models of fluvial and tidal environments to identify which processes are missing and how the model results depend on the magnitude of the transverse slope parameter. We found that the unrealistic incision in the model depends on grid size and sediment suspension. However, artificially increasing downslope sediment transport to balance the incision and to get a realistic morphology results in an unrealistic amount of sediment transport. Therefore, you can either model realistic sediment transport rates or realistic morphology. A present calibration practice may cause an order of magnitude error in either morphology or in the rate of morphological change. This shows that model results severely depend on choices made by the modeler. This is true for any model that includes sediment transport, long-term idealized models and shorter-term models that are used for engineering studies. Model design should therefore be optimized differently, depending on its application.